Well, thanks for talking to us, Paul. You must be excited to be back at the Stars.
Yeah, definitely. I love playing here. I love the fans. I love like the community of the team and everybody here. It's exciting to be back, and I look forward to the rest of the season.
What did you make of tonight's game? The first period, everything looked great. One of the best periods we've seen all season, and then it just kind of fell apart after that.
Yeah, I thought the first period was really good. Everybody was shooting the puck, we were playing the systems and stuff, and I think we just turned off for the first 5 minutes of the second period, and then let the refs get in our head a little bit with some silly penalties, and I think it just snowballed from there. And yeah, it's a tough one to lose, but I think we'll bounce back and go into Cardiff tomorrow with our heads up and take this frustration down there.
If I can just ask you, to maybe describe a little bit about your time across in the States, from when you left to coming back, if you can.
Yeah, it's just an experience that I never thought that I'd get. Playing for Chicago in the rookie tournament, putting on that NHL jersey, it was a dream come true, to be honest. It's not really sunk in yet what I've accomplished there. But still, I'm eager to get back over there. I'm happy to be back here, but still, I want to be back over there. But going through all the systems from the NHL prospects all the way through to the CHL, it was an experience that I'll never forget.
What was the quality like of some of the players that you were playing with?
The quality is, you can see that Quick here, he's come from the East Coast. Isaacs comes from the East Coast, so it is a high quality. I think that it's a little better than over here because the guys are all around the same age. Like, the age gap here is quite big, but it's the fact that everybody over there has got something to work towards. So they have a good year in the East Coast, they can go up to the AHL, they get to the AHL, then they're one step away from the NHL. So I think it's just that willingness to work hard is just a bit different over here, but that's not taking credit away from the guys over here, because guys over here do work really hard to stay in the best shape and to be the best team in the league.
You said it was an experience. What have you personally learnt across there from some of the players that you can bring back to help the Stars this season?
Fundamentals mostly, the skill side of the game. So the skating side is a really big aspect over there, and I've learned a lot of new things over there that I've never heard of before, so I'm going to bring that into my game and hopefully work on that for if I get back over there. Just the whole system side of it too, the shooting of the shooting, using your points, and it's just a different way of life over there. They live and breathe hockey, whereas some guys over here have jobs and whatnot because that's what they have to do to survive. But yeah, I've learnt a lot over there, and I'm going to hopefully take it into my game and make the GB team again and then push on from there.
Now, I know you've been keeping an eye on the Stars. What have you made of the roster this year so far from what you've seen?
I think on paper the roster is a really, really good team, if not just as good as last year's team. But I just think there's a bit... they're not really clicking a little bit. Like, you can see in the first period today that we can work together, but I think it's just the mentality. We just need to keep working at it and just to get a little bit of spark, a little bit of jump in our steps, and just move on. Like, yeah, there's been a bad start to the season, but there's still a lot of hockey to play, and there's no reason why we can't end up at the mid-table or anything like that. And to be fair, Dundee have had a pretty tough start to the year with the teams that they've played. But yeah, I think that there's a really good chance we all pull together now. We've got the decor at 6D, that we can have the goals less again, like 3 goals today. I think we can make that a lesser and make it a 1 or 2 goal game for us. And then hopefully the forwards take a little less pressure off them playing defence and they can concentrate more on scoring goals.
And I know you spoke about it briefly a couple of minutes ago, but yourself, is the aspiration to get back across to the States then after your experience you've had there?
Yeah, definitely. I've always wanted to go back over there after my 2 years playing in Canada. It's what I want to do. It's what I want to tell people when I'm older. Yeah, I played hockey over there. I want to do something that not many people have done before over here. I want to get British hockey over there, because the amount of times that I got asked what's the Elite League like over here, and I just say it's where all the guys go that are not getting what they want out of that league. They come over here and play. It's a good league. So I think that's one thing too. I want to push the British players and get a little bit more awareness of British guys that are coming up through the British hockey.
Well, that's great. Thanks for talking to us, Paul. Best of luck with the rest of the season.
Cheers. Thank you.
Well, Jeff, two goals up tonight at the end of the first period, and probably one of the best periods that we can say we've had here this year. What went wrong?
Well, we took too many penalties. I think we got caught on the penalty kill and gave up two penalties against them, and they capitalized on both. And I think we completely dominated the first period, and I think those goals in the second kind of set us back. And I think we took the play to them for, I want to say, 50-55 minutes. I think we had the run of play pretty much the whole game, and we get a bad bounce off a skate and it goes in and costs us the game. And it's when things are going bad, things like that tend to happen, and we just need to be positive and kind of pick ourselves up. And we can't sulk. We got a big game down in Cardiff, and a long bus ride ahead of us.
Is it quite concerning the amount of goals the team is losing on the penalty kill for you?
Well, I wouldn't say that. I mean, do you know what the stats are?
No.
Okay. Well, I mean, I don't think penalty kill is that bad when you compare it to the rest of the league. I think that it's a spotlight when goals get scored on. But it was unfortunate that we took penalties. I mean, the penalties were, I think, 6-7-1 maybe, and the one that they got was a coincidental penalty. So I mean, yeah, it's frustrating, and I'm sure I heard a lot of frustration in the stands, and I expect that, and they can pile it on me if they want. But again, we're working hard, and we're gonna turn this around. And again, there's a lot of season to play, and we just need to get that run and those few lucky bounces. And we had a chance that we could have put the game away. We could have been up 4-5-0 at certain points during the game, and we just didn't get the fall and the puck to fall. And credit to them, they stuck with it, and they got a lucky one at the end, which I personally don't think was in. It should have been counted as a goal, but those are the way the game is sometimes.
Can I ask you on Paul Swindlehurst, how delighted you are to have him back in the squad?
Certainly a boost, I think. It gives us a full complement of D-back there. I think, we're moving out of our zone a lot quicker, and, the guys have more energy. And, I don't think we spend, a lot of time in our zone tonight. I think, the goals that they did score, two on a power play and one on a rush. And, it'll be good to have him back there. And, again, as the season wears on, we'll have more energy and can push.
And you've mentioned already about Cardiff tomorrow and a couple of hard games next weekend as well.
They're all playoff games for us now. We're chasing everyone above us, and we need to start pegging some guys in. And if we hang our heads tonight and go down there with the wrong attitude, then we'll have lost the game before we get on the bus. So we need to. We need to just be positive and kind of take the good things. And there was a lot of good things tonight. And, the scoreline didn't show it, but there was a lot of good things, and I've seen a lot of good things out of guys. And, it's going to come together, and, we just need to be diligent about things.
Well, best of luck tomorrow, Jeff. Thanks for talking to us.
Cheers. Thank you.